What is up, world? In this video, I'm going to be attempting to make a robot that can draw anything. If I tell this robot to draw an elephant riding a bicycle on Mars, it will draw it. If I tell this robot to draw a robot drawing a robot, it will draw it. How am I going to do this, you might ask? I am so glad you asked. I got my plan right here. I'm already 80% done with it. Let's keep going.
I've done some research and I've learned that a drawing robot is part of a family of machines called CNC machines. I'd tell you what CNC stands for, but nobody cares. To build this drawing robot, I'm planning on using parts I've found around my home, such as rails, a pulley system, and stepper motors. I'm going to use an Arduino to control the stepper motors to make everything move, and I'm going to 3D print parts to build the supports and bring all these mechanical components together. It turns out a 3D printer is also a CNC machine. So in a way, by using it to build another CNC machine, I'm helping it reproduce.
I've completed the first axis of the drawing robot, and this is the play-by-play analysis. First thing I did was I attached a rail and stepper motor to some 3D printed supports. Next, I set up the ends of the pulley system. My original plan was incredibly dumb, as you can see here, which was to 3D print a rod at the end of one of the supports, but that immediately fell off, so I needed to come up with a new plan. I noticed that the drill bit was roughly the right size, so I drilled the bit into one of the supports and then removed it from the drill. Who needs that bit anyways? With that, I was able to attach the center platform piece and complete the pulley system. Now it's time to attach the pen. Some duct tape will do for now. I'm about ready to fire it up, but first I need to find my power cord. Where did that thing go? Is it in my big box of cords? Surely it's in my big box of cords. It ended up being in my desk drawer. I plug it in and here we go. It sort of works, but the pin falls off. Nothing a little bit more duct tape won't fix. And it works. The robot can now draw in one dimension. Sort of. If I hold it down.
So at this point, I'm feeling pretty good about things, so I decided to set up a Zoom call and show it off to my sister.
Wow. So that's very cool, but why did you make this?
No reason.
You just did this for fun?
Yeah.
Oh my god. So it can only make one line?
Yeah, for now. Isn't that cool?
But it's not even straight. Is that intentional or is that an error?
As you just saw, people's minds are already blown away by the single axis robot, but it's time to make it even cooler and add a second axis. I'm going to do the cool snappy finger thing. You ready for it? 3, 2, 1. Sorry, my editor's a little bit slow. Wait for it. Wait for it. Boom. Here we go. It has been a month and a half, by the way. In addition to the second axis, I have added switches so the robot knows where it is. I have screwed it down to this board so it doesn't move all over the place. And I have 3D printed the center pin holder, so we don't have to use duct tape anymore. And there's a servo that allows the pen to go up and down. But of all of this, the most important thing I've done is I have added eyes so the robot can see where it's going. Alrighty, let's go ahead. Sorry about that. My editor was a little bit too fast that time. But what I was trying to say is it's time to test things out. So what I've done is I've written some code. And what this code will do once I plug in the robot is it will move the pen to a random location, drop down the pen, move to another random location, bring up the pen, and repeat this process over and over and over again until I unplug the robot. Let's see what happens. Alrighty, here we go. Alrighty, I've changed nothing, but let's try it again. Take two. Take three, I realized that the board the robot's on was under a screw, which was making it uneven, screwing up where it was. So here we go. All right, there are definitely some kinks that need to be worked on for sure. I'm really proud of this one. I'm going to hang it up on the fridge. At first, it might look like just a bunch of random lines, but if you look closer, no, even closer, you'll see that the lines represent the chaos of the universe. It's actually quite deep. All right, editor, on to the next scene. You ready? 3, 2, 1.
Nice job, editor.
What the?
If anyone's looking to be an editor, I am hiring. Since the last time I saw you guys, I have successfully fried not one, but two Arduinos. You see these two? They don't work anymore. But besides that, things have gone pretty well. I decided to name the robot Drew. And the name of the game recently has been eliminating any unnecessary motion in the robot. I added some stoppers to the ends to make sure the axes don't slide up and down. I put some weights on the board to make sure that doesn't slide all over the place. The biggest issue is that Drew's a little crooked, which the root cause of that is I have no idea what I'm doing, and I should go back and redesign Drew's supports to make sure he's not crooked. But at this point, Drew's crookedness is really one of the imperfections that make him who he is, and we don't want to change that. And for the most part, things have worked out really well. Check out this masterpiece that Drew drew. Not only can Drew draw cats, but he can draw anything that can be converted into lines, which today with online tools, pretty much everything can be converted into lines. For example, this picture I took of the largest frying pan in Washington. Drew can also draw people. Here, Drew, Drew, Drew. Here, Drew, Drew, Drew. Here, Drew, Drew, Drew. Here, Drew, Drew, my sister Rachel. Here, Drew, Drew, my friend Maddie. Here, Drew, Drew, my friend Young. And lastly, here, Drew, Drew, me. All the drawings so far are based on images either taken or made by me, or images I found online. The next step is for Drew to be able to generate images all by himself. And to do that, we're going to use the magic of artificial intelligence, and in this case specifically, DALLE 2. DALLE 2 is AI that takes some text and turns it into a picture. So I've written a script that asks the user, what should Drew draw? The user says something like an elephant riding a bicycle on Mars. That text gets sent to DALLE 2, which generates an image. The script then translates that image into Drew's language, and Drew draws it. I've asked friends for ideas of what Drew should draw. Here are the results. To start, we got a robot drawing a robot drawing a robot, which of course this picture was also drawn by a robot. Next, we got a classy Eiffel Tower. Here we've got an elephant on skates, your pretty standard unicorn in a UFO. Here we got a half human, half kangaroo. The boy who lived singing some karaoke. Just a cat doing some juggling. I think these two go together pretty well. On the left, we got someone with a lot of eyes, and on the right, we got an alien creature. These last four, I actually don't know what they are, because Drew drew these without any input whatsoever. Must be some sort of bug. Another feature I implemented in Drew was a one-player Pictionary mode where you can ask Drew to draw something random. And how this works is that the script will call ChatGPT to come up with something for Drew to draw. For those who don't know, ChatGPT is a different AI system that's a chatbot. So you can ask it questions and it will return answers in text form, and its answers are pretty incredible. So with that all hooked up, all we do is type rand in the script and see what Drew draws. For example, this was a smiling lemon wearing a hat, bow tie, and sunglasses while holding a bit of parsley. And that concludes the story of Drew. This video was really fun to make. If you liked it, please subscribe. I got a lot of help from online resources, open source software, etc. for this project. I have a list of a bunch of them in the description below. Check those out. Especially big shout out to the channel How To Mechatronics, which did an awesome project on building a drawing robot that I used as a template for this project. If you have any questions, concerns, insults, words of affirmation, confessions, haikus, please comment below or hop on my Discord linked in the description.